What is going on, guys? It's your boy Sneed here, and we got some weekend league gameplay at the moment. But after this game, I don't want to tell you my record because that would give it away. But we are having a very good weekend league. This guy is a top rated player. I'm about to pop up his stats on the screen. He's like top 13, 25, 20, something like that in the month. So he's a very good opponent. This game is a banger, comes down to the end. But if you guys already haven't subscribed, smash that like button, and we're going to get into some top gameplay. Peace.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Don't stop that motor. Play action. It's Griffin. Well, he's going to take a shot right away. It's caught inside the 25. The ball comes out, and it's picked up by the Patriots. So the turnover forced, and a wonderful job on a big return.
And how about the convoy that got created to help him get all the way back upfield? I mean, that's the part that people miss on. That's practice. That's worked on. It doesn't just happen in a game and everyone rallies. They discuss it prior to, and everyone knows their role when they create a turnover like that.
And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. A solid pickup of 12 yards, and now they're knocking on the door. They'll run it with Kamara, and he's in. Touchdown, Raiders. A 3-yard touchdown run, and the Raiders have taken the early lead. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up. Meaning, when you get on a guy, you just stay right there, and each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Throwing now, Griffin on first down, escaping the pressure right. This is caught by Antonio Brown. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. And a nice gain at 21 yards. On first and 10, it's Griffin, buying time to his left. Now he'll throw, oh man, it's caught inside the 10. And he just falls short down at the 1-yard line.
I think this defense is still trying to recover from that last play, so you wonder if they were ready for this one. You have to imagine their defensive coaches are yelling at them to get focused, because if they don't, more plays like that will result in giving up points.
First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. They'll try and pound it in with Bettis. He's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. Well, go ahead and strap in, partner. Less than 2 minutes in, had the score on the one side. A quick answer, though, to get the equalizer.
Sometimes you get that sense of urgency that ratchets up, right? When you give up an early touchdown like that, you just know, you're like, okay, how do we go back and equalize things? Can we get it done fast? And they absolutely did. Essentially, we're back to even, aren't we?
Fair catch signaled for and taken at about the 15-yard line. The Raider offense set to get this drive started, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. Try the right side here, and he'll be tackled at about the 35. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it, but a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Partner, those are back-to-back 6-yard runs, and if they're going to continue to get those types of plays, shoot, you just keep running the same stuff, don't you?
That was first and 10, then second and 4. Now first and 10 again. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down. The gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
On third down, Griffin. Open man there is Patterson, complete. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 18 yards on his first catch of the game. It's a first down. The throw is RG3. Flushed out right. Bearing it out deep for Wood. And this is caught. And they're into the end zone, but it's not verified yet. Hold on. There is a flag down. So retract the yardage and retract the touchdown.
And retract the chunk play. Big strike there to get the touchdown. Now they've got to take it back and see if they've got another one still in their arsenal.
Grab for the football, and he's going to come down with it. And he's finally taken down, and it's a big gain there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. These two teams all tied after one. Try to pound it in, Kamara. A minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. And the ball smacked down on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. This will be caught at about the 5. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Alvin Kamara, he scored on the ground and through the air. And the Raiders have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
That's where we are.
Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. And this carries into the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen.
It got his man complete. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. Carry now for Bettis. Breakthrough
some contact, but unable to reach the 40. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. Out of the gun, Griffin. He'll go underneath here to Elliott, and he's going to get this inside the 30. Give him 14 on that one, and a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Now a throw left sideline here is complete. And he's going to have a first down on a gain of about 10, and that'll take us to the two-minute warning. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the gun, it's Griffin, flush to his right. That's complete, right around the 8. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. An 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up.
All the receivers in the league are plenty good enough, otherwise they wouldn't make it in the NFL. But the ones that go to the Pro Bowl, they have refined route-running ability.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. On the return, here's the dangerous Cordero Patterson. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. These two teams trading touchdowns here in what has been a back-and-forth first half.
And ordinarily, we're trying to figure out how to break out of a stalemate. Here, you're trying to figure out if you can slow someone down.
And that's caught inside the 35.
I'm the best in the game.
And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Randy Moss. An 80-yard touchdown. And the Raiders are able to strike quickly for 6. One play, 80 yards. Pretty easy drive to recap.
It certainly is, but not so easy to execute. Starting on your own 20, you want something to kickstart your drive and get it off to a nice start. They went for the whole thing and got it. That's a great way to send a message to the opposing team.
Taking it about the 1. And now deep in his own territory, he coughs up the football, and the Raiders pick it up.
There's never a good place on the field to fumble the ball. Let's just call it as it is.
But definitely not in your own red zone.
In your own red zone, it's heightened, isn't it? Because you're almost automatically giving up a score and the momentum, and everything just changes for your team.
Yeah, so the kickoff fumble, now great field position.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
There as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Running with Kamara. And he is in. Touchdown, Raiders. ALVIN KAMARA on his way to a monster game. 3 first-half touchdowns. And the Raiders able to extend that advantage. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
Let's go! Come on!
The
Pats at the line, ready to go.
And with still more than a minute to go in the half, time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. On first down, Griffith on the move to his left. And the open receiver is Robert Woods. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down. They'll roll him out right. And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. From the red zone now, here's Griffin on first down. And that's going to be caught to a touchdown. Randy Moss there to make the grab. And the Patriots are back within a score. These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today is track shoes. That's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far. Fun to watch. And that one bounces out of the back of the end zone, so we'll start the drive at the 25 on the touchback. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock out and go to the locker room.
Now Griffin on first down, eluding the pressure right. He'll run it. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Off the play fake. Here's Griffin. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked up by two-time All-Pro Rodney Harrison. He will be brought down as time is now running on this first half of action. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Both these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. New England with a first down as they begin the drive. And we have seen a lot on the scoreboard here in this quarter. So sometimes you talk to me about tendency breakers on offense. These defenses struggling. Are there tendency breakers on defense? And that's caught inside the 35. And they finally get him down, but not before he reaches the 34. They'll throw on first down with Griffin. Got a man, it's Patterson complete. And they'll get this one to about the 20-yard line. It's a first down, his fourth catch of the game after having three in the first half. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Got a man over the middle, it's Woods. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, people have to come up with schemes to limit him, and what a lot of teams...
And he's in! Touchdown, Patriots! A 12-yard touchdown grab. And the Patriots are within a
tying this one up. CD, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point, because you got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. The Raider offense set to get this drive started. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. And he's brought down after a very nice gain. 34 yards there and a first down. They went with the nickel look defensively, so they had five defensive backs in there. Didn't help them stop the run.
Yeah, I love that, the nickel look. 5 cents, five DBs. But what also happens then, you take a big body off the field in order to insert that guy. So you're taking a big off for a little. And oftentimes you can run the football effectively against that defense.
And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one good for 13 and a Raider first down. Ground. This is Kamara. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it? Three plays? Three first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they get to that end zone real fast.
Staying on the ground on first with Kamara. Down right around the 25. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
He was trying to get it to his running back, Alvin Kamara, and it's third down. Is intercepted. Picked off at the 15. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. They thought they were going to break the tie. The defense had other plans. They were already in field goal range, but boom, an interception.
I don't know if this was a case of being a little bit too greedy with the opportunity to put points on the board, but give credit to the guys on the defensive side. Hung in there, battled, and made a key play.
After the interception, here's Griffin. Throw left side, complete. That's Elliott. And he'll go out of bounds, it looks like, right at the 40.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
He's going to take off with it. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Taking matters into his own hands, and he picks up 4 yards and a first down.
That's something we have not seen him do to this point, and that's take the ball, tuck it, and run.
Exactly right. His first carry of the game. I guess he picked a good time to do it.
He certainly did. Not only did he have the element of surprise, he's making sure he's judicious in taking off.
A gain of 3, second down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Now Elliott. And this will be taken across midfield and into Raider territory.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Escaping the pressure right. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off. It made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. They'll try and run for it. Oh, and I think he went backward. He did. The Patriots come up empty on fourth down. And this defense is going to get the football back near midfield, right at the 48. Midfield and just shy of the 40. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Well, that'll help the old passing stats. Remember, it was a pop pass, so it's not a wide receiver run there, Charles.
I like the way that you scored it, and that's exactly how it goes into the books. But remember, he's had success throwing the ball the standard way in this game, and here, this little top pass, it goes for good yardage.
Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. They'll get 34 yards there. On the ground, Kamara. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Raiders have moved out in front. And let's not forget, he had the receiving touchdown earlier. Now a trio of rushing touchdowns. Quite a performance.
Diversification, that's all you can talk about. His ability to do everything leaves him on the field on every down on offense, because you can hand it to him, as we've seen. But you say 3 rushing touchdowns, and of course throw it to him where he's caught one as well.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Pats at the line, ready to go.
And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock.
On first down, Griffin. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks. First and 10, Griffin, and he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete, and he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. From the shotgun, Griffin, flushed out right. And crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by the safety, D'Angelo Hall. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage. But instead, he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
A 10th carry for Kamara. Kamara's got the first down and then some. Touchdown, Raiders. Alvin Kamara, 41 yards. And the forced turnover on defense leads to 6 points. And that rushing touchdown is 4th, puts him just 1 shy of the NFL record in a single game.
And we all know he would love to get to that record and even beyond it, but he doesn't need to in order to impress in this one, does he? What a performance. What an absolute great game that he's had here in this one.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. New England with a first down as they begin the drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Just go out there loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
Throwing on first down, Griffin. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. Operating from the gun, Griffin. And this is caught now for a late touchdown.
one's not over yet. Okay, game on. Don't go anywhere yet. You got a one-score game now. Probably going to rely on the onside kick coming up.
Yeah, they have to. It's not a high percentage play, but it's better than not having a chance at all. And that's when you put your leapers and your flyers on one side, get that high hop, and hope that one of the guys can come up with it.
And on the other side, get that hands team ready.
No doubt about it.
And the hands team for the Raiders able to secure it. And they just about had to get that recovery to have any chance. They only have one timeout. You look at the clock, and let's do the math here, Charles. This one's pretty much over.
Now, we do have a chart here, don't we, that tells us about the timeouts.
You do. I'm not as smart as you.
And in looking at it, you're exactly right. The chart's not going to help them here at all. They're pretty much done at this stage. They had to have that recovery.
The Patriots will take their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. After the pickup of five, here's second and five. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
Here's Kamara trying to run for it. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. So barring something extraordinary here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Yeah, we've got to find two scores. So, you know, we're not going to exactly move it over there yet. It can be done, but boy, it's going to be a little bit of a stretch for them, isn't it?
Yeah, they would have to move incredibly quick and have some luck, too. The Pats at the line, ready to go. They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. Because now, you're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence. And that will be incomplete. Four ticks left here on the clock. Second and 10 from the 33-yard line. One last shot for RG3. He's going to let it fly. It's caught inside the 25. He's in. Are you kidding me?
How do you get that out?
One of the most improbable ways to finish a game. And they do win it on the final play. Doesn't affect the outcome, but hey, nice job there to put it in the end zone for the final play.
Could it affect other things? Sometimes these types of scores are ones that we don't consider big at the time. Then later on we find out maybe that was a time.